الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا ما علمتنا وزدنا علما. اللهم اجعلنا من يستمع القول فيتبع أحسنه. والسلام. In the Surah Ali Imran, we have reached to this ayah. أفمن اتبع رضوان الله كمن باء بسخط من الله ومأواه جهنم وبئس المصير. This beautiful ayat, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, أَفَمَنْ اتَّبَعَ. It's kind of like questioning. But definitely, the question here to make the people, أَفَمَنْ اتَّبَعَ, the one who follow the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the one who returned with the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanAllah. وَمَأْوَاهُ جَهَنَّمْ. And he will be in Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, definitely, the one who obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is he equivalent with the one who returned, or the one who disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mean return with the wrath and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Definitely they are not. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want them to say, they are not equal. The one who follow the commands, the one who follow the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is different than the one who does not follow. And he said, wa ma'wahu. So فَقَدْ بَاءَ بِسَخَطْ, the one who does not بَاءَ, the word بَاءَ here always means there's a consequence, severe consequences come with something as a consequences for evil action. And he said وَمَأْوَاهُ جَهَنَّمْ, and he will be in Jahannam. وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ, subhanAllah, Jahannam, because he did not follow the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said here, هُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, هُمْ دَرَجَاتٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَاللَّهُ بَصِيرٌ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ. الدرجات, he said, they are levels by the side of Allah. They are not the same. And this means the Muslimin, the Mu'mineen, and the Kuffar, both. But when you say darajat, the word darajat means goes up, which is mean the mu'mineen. They have levels. When it comes to the ranks, steps. So in Arabic, levels mean ranks, one rank. And when it comes to munafiqeen, so the munafiqeen fi darakat, fi darak al asfal, in the munafiqeen fi darak al asfal. When it comes to darakat, mean their levels is low. So darajat and darakat, remember, darajat for the mu'mineen and darakat for the kafirin, for the munafiqeen. So they are three seem, hum darajat, the mu'mineen, they are darajat. SubhanAllah, wallahu basirun bima ya'malun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what they are doing. Allah knows their action. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said, لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِهِ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَإِنْ كَانُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind the mu'min. Manna means Allah has favored someone. Allah has bestowed some favors, some ni'mah upon some people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminded them, he granted the mu'min something. Allah have gave the mu'min something, which is he have sent a messenger from among themselves. إِذْ بَعَثَ, بَعَثَ, he sent رَسُولًا, a messenger, مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ. مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ mean a human being, one explanation. Or if أَنفُسِهِمْ, he's from them, they know who he is. He's Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was known as الصادق, الأمين. مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ, from among themselves. And they said, call could be a man from their kind. He did not send an angel, as Allah subhanahu, as they requested an angel. He said, if we were to send him an angel, we would make him a man. So you understand what he's saying. So he from among themselves. And here there was some tafsir, min anfusihim, from them, mean they know who he is, exactly where he came from, which is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And there's one qira'ah, said, min anfasihim. Min anfasihim mean from their best, the best one. So anfusihim from among himself, anfusihim mean he is the most noble one. As Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he came from the most noble tribe. He said, Allah have chosen Kinana from the children of Ismail, the tribe Kinana. And he said, Allah chose Quraysh from Kinana. Kinana is big. Ismail, then he chose Kinana, and from Kinana he chose the tribe of Quraysh. He talked about himself, and he said from Quraysh he chose the tribe of Hashim, Bani Hashim. And he said he chose me from Bani Hashim. So he's the best from the best and the best. So he chose Ibrahim, as Allah mentioned the Quran, in Allah astafa Adam wa Nuhan wa ala Ibrahim. Allah have chosen, mean Allah favored Allah Adam and Nuh and the family of Ibrahim. And one of the family of Ibrahim, Ismail. And he chose from the children of Ismail, Bani Kinana. From Bani Kinana, Quraysh, the tribe of Quraysh. From Quraysh, the branch of Hashim, and he chose him from the branch of Hashim. And I tell you how noble this tribe, Quraysh. All the major Sahaba from them. Abu Bakr from Quraysh, Umar from Quraysh, Uthman from Quraysh, Ali radiallahu anhu Quraysh, Hassan, Hussein, Khalid, Walid, Zubair al-Awwam, and all this from Quraysh. The best people ever existed. And on top of them is Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, a man from among you, you know who he is, you know how noble he is, you know how truthful he is, you know how honest he is. He did not bring someone from outside. He did not bring an angel from you. You should know, why don't you believe him? Before Islam, you were saying he's the truthful, he's a sadiq, he's ameen, he's trustworthy. How come what happened now? SubhanAllah said, yatlu alayhim ayatihi. So he recited the ayat. Till what's in the Quran? They're ameen, they were illiterate. So he recited the Quran. Of course, Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he was illiterate himself. He wasn't able to read and write, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran, and he was able to memorize the Quran. So then he said, yuzakkihim, yattu alayhim ayatihi, wa yuzakkihim. Yuzakkihim mean purify them. He was purifying the Quraysh. By what? By taking them away from the shirk, from the kufr. Yuzakkihim, the word yuzakkihim mean purify them. Then he said again, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابُ وَالْحَكْمَةِ. At the beginning, he's yatlu, recites the Quran. Now, وَيُعَلِّمُهُمْ الْكِتَابُ وَالْحَكْمَةِ. Mean he teach them the rules in the Quran. The halal, the haram, what we should do, what we shouldn't do, and all the stuff. He was teaching them the book of the Quran, وَالْحِكْمَةِ. Al-hikmah, the sunnah. So there's no different. All from Allah. All revelation, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaching the Quran and the hikmah. The hikmah is the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, وَإِن كَانُوا مِن قَبْلِ لَفِي ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ. مِن قَبْلِ, and they were before the sending of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before the message of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he became to them as a messenger, they were in ضَلَالٍ مُبِينٍ, they were lost. They were in the ignorance era. They didn't know any better. They didn't know any good, subhanAllah. قبل أن يتيهم, before Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he came to them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here said, is like in a way, he telling the mu'min, أَوْلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ مُصِيبَةً قَدْ أَصَبْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا قُلْ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. عتاب, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling the mu'min, when you lost 70 men in the battle of Uhud, أَوْلَمَّا أَصَابَتْكُمْ, when the musibah, من the battle of Uhud, when you lost the battle of Uhud, musibah, you were afflicted, you were basically lost the battle of Uhud, then, and you forget, because you have, many people got killed in Uhud, 70 great men, they were killed in Uhud, definitely, big loss. But he said, did you forget the victory in Badr? قَدْ أَصَيْتُمْ مِثْلَيْهَا, you have caused them, or caused double the amount of loss for Quraysh in the battle of Badr, which is you killed 70 and you hold hostages another 70. So 140, double. So double the amount. قُلْتُمْ أَنَّ هَذَا, said, how this happened to us? And a lot of people ask him, how could Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the battle and the greatest men ever exist, they lose the battle? They say, you said, how this happened to us? Ya Rasulullah, we are the muwahideen. We are the one who believe in the oneness of Allah. They are mushrikeen. They tried to harm Rasulullah. They prevented them from making salah, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are here the supporters. We're muhajireen, left everything behind. The ansar, we believe in your oneness. You believe in making salah and so on. We gave up everything for you, Allah. How this happened to us? Subhanallah. Allah said, قُلْ أُمِينَ مُحَمَّدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ أَنفُسِهِمْ. It's because of you. SubhanAllah. So as a punishment, as a consequences, SubhanAllah, through their actions. So because you did not follow the command of your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, for the archers, stay on the mount. Do not leave your spot. No matter what happened to us. Till I let you know, till I tell you to leave, do not leave your locations. Do not leave your spots. So من عندي أنفسكم, because of you. It's a consequences. SubhanAllah. So then you left your spot. And beside this, before this, when they insisted, the young men in Medina, Rasulullah, that they told him, Ya Rasulullah, Rasulullah, I'm going to fight the kuffar in Medina, in the alleys, in the streets. So this way we'll beat him. We'll win. So the young ones, the one who did not participate in Badr, they said, no, Ya Rasulullah, we'll go there. We're not afraid of them. We want to go there. You know, Shabab, excited, SubhanAllah, radiallahu anhum. They have the best intention, of course. And Rasulullah said, okay. He went, put his helmet on, and he, SubhanAllah, came back. Said, so the senior Sahaba said, why did you tell Rasulullah that? He did not want to leave. Then Rasulullah, he had his helmet on. He said, Ya Rasulullah, sorry, we apologize. Wallahi, we don't know. We do whatever you want. Of course, they didn't want to disobey Rasulullah, but they really, in a way, they insisted on him. Kept on, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah, Ya Rasulullah. Then he did this. Rasulullah said, too late. This one's not coming out. Let's go out. So one of them, as a consequence, because the tafsir, either because the archers left, or because you insisted to do something different than what Rasulullah wanted. So one of the two tafsirs. So من عندي أنفسكم, that's why you lost the battle, because of this. Even though you are muhideen, even though you believe in the oneness of Allah, even though the one who gave victory to Rasulullah, then SubhanAllah, this من عندي أنفسكم. And this, SubhanAllah, the attitude of many people, when there's something happened to them, they try to say, I didn't do anything. I don't know why this happened to me. Why this happened to me? There's beautiful ayah in the Quran. Allah subhanahu said, مَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةً فَمِنَ اللَّهِ. Everything good happened to you is from Allah. وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةً فَمِنْ نَفْسَكَ. And the bad things happen to you as a consequence for your actions. So when something happened, anything is a test to purify you, or there is a consequence for your actions. So that's what it is. Then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. Allah is able to give you victory. Allah is able to make you victorious all the time. So, but this is not the case. Now you have the shortcoming. This what happened as a teaching to them. As a lesson to everyone. Then he said, وَمَا أَصَابَكُمْ يَوْمَ الْتَقَى الْجَمْعَانِ. So what happened to you, losing the battle, when they met the army of Muslimin and the army of Quraysh, the Kuffar, what happened? فَبِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. So Allah knows about it. Allah allowed that to happen. فَبِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. By the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah allowed this to happen. So nothing goes without the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, وَلِيَعْلَمُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلِيَعْلَمُ النَّكْسَ أَيَا الَّذِينَ نَافَقُوا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could distinguish, could tell to you and the day of judgment who's the mu'mineen and who's the munafiqeen, the hypocrites. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold us accountable for our actions, not for what He know. Even Allah knows this are hypocrites and those are mu'mineen, but you have to act upon. Because the day of judgment, He would tell you did this and this and that, and He would tell him you did this and this and that. So Allah will reward you or punish you based upon not what He know, based upon your actions. You understand? Even though He knows those are hypocrites. But this is the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and subhanAllah, He said, وَلِيَعْلَمُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. So He shows who's the true mu'mineen, and expose who's the true munafiqeen, subhanAllah. Then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَلِيَعْلَمُ الْمُنَافِقِينَ, وَقِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا. وَلِيَعْلَمَ الَّذِينَ نَافَقُوا وَقِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا. SubhanAllah, when the Abdullah ibn Ubayy, قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا أَوْ ادْفَعُوا. So tell them, come back. Fight with us. Because Abdullah ibn Ubay, he took 300 men and went back to Medina. And he was the leader of hypocrites. Said, there's no qital, no fight. Said, ta'alu, Abdullah ibn Haram, he told him, come on back. One third of the army, a lot to go back. They were 1,000. The Quraysh, they were 3,000. They were 3 times more, now it's more than four times more. It's hard. So Abdullah ibn Haram, he was from the Ansar, he told him, come back. Either fight with us or just sit there. Don't fight. Show like you are there. So the kuffar, they will be a little afraid. They see a big number. They refuse, subhanAllah. They told him, if they're going to become victorious, they go into the Medina. They're going to take your money. They're going to kill your children and wives and so on. Just sit there. They refuse, subhanAllah. So Abdullah ibn Haram, radiallahu anhu, said, subhanAllah, he cursed them. He said, may Allah curse you. And he went back, subhanAllah, to fight, and he was died as a shaheed, radiyallahu anhu wa arda. قال, he said, قاتل في سبيل الله أودفعوا قالوا لو نعلم قتالا لاتبعناكم. We know there's no fight going to happen. They told him, Abdullah, the hypocrites, they said, لو نعلم قتالا لاتبعناكم. If we know there's a fight going to happen, we will be there. But we know there's nothing going to happen. So because of their hypocrisy, and because Rasulullah ﷺ did not listen to the suggestion of Abdullah ibn Ubay. Abdullah ibn Ubay, the leader of the munafiqin, the hypocrites, he wants to fight from the Medina. Why he wants to fight from the Medina? Because one thing, there is nobody going to see whether he's going to fight or not. Not for a good cause. Because he will be hiding his house, because everyone will be fighting by his house. So nobody will know who's fighting and who does not. So Rasulullah ﷺ followed the opinion of the shabab, the youth. So he went out. So Abdullah ibn Ubay, now he went revenge. He said, he didn't listen to me. And there's no fight going to be, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu said, هُمْ لِلْكُفْرِ يَوْمَ إِذٍ أَقْرَوْهُمْ الْإِيمَانِ. See, they are closer to be kuffar than the iman. So sometimes you have a lot of good deeds, then you are closer to the iman. Some people, they have a lot of bad deeds, so the kuffar are closer than the iman. That day, because their actions, they are closer to kufr than the iman. Subhanallah. يَقُولُونَ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ مَا لَيْسَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. Look at this. They say in their mouth, were different than what they utter. They utter different than what they conceal. So they conceal their heart different than what they say. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَقُولُونَ, they say in their mouth. He could have said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they say different than what they act. But they say it in their mouth. They utter different than they, in their mouth, or from their mouth, different than what they act, what's in their hearts. But Allah to emphasize on this one. This, they utter things different than what they conceal. Allah want to expose those people, subhanAllah, to make him expose among everyone, like scandal for them. Imagine, 700 people after the battle, they came back and said, listen, those are ran away. They came, they could have fought with us, they could defend us, but Allah want to expose the munafiqeen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to expose their hypocrisy. So subhanAllah, he said, imagine this ayah in the Quran came against them, exposing them, and what the Muslimin, when they came back, they said about them, they did not help us. They left the Medina, they left the battlefield, and they went, subhanAllah, to back home, and they refused to be with us. Imagine the situation, subhanAllah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows who they are. Allah knows when they are, said, Wallahu a'lamu bima yaktumun. Allah knows everyone we conceal, and He knows your intention, and knows whether it's right or bad, and He knows the hypocrites from the mu'min. Wallahu a'lam. Allah knows ma yaktumun. Alimun bidat sudur. Knows what you can see in your heart, subhanAllah. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, الَّذِينَ قَالُوا لِإِخْوَانِهِمْ وَقَعَدُوا. الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِخْوَانِهِمْ وَقَعَدُوا لَوْ أَطَاعُونَ مَا قُتِلُوا قُلْ فَدْرُوا عَنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ مَوْتْ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. This is the last ayah, inshallah. So the one who told their brothers, so the hypocrites, the munafiqeen, they told their brothers, which is the one who was there. The one now, the people, some munafiqeen, they were in the battlefield and they were killed. Because some munafiqeen, they stayed there for what? For the war booties, to get some benefits. So however, they told, if they listen to us, they will never get killed. Look at the mentality. So because you're at the battlefield, you stayed there, that's why you got killed. Otherwise, you would never kill, subhanAllah. SubhanAllah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanAllah, knows best. He said, فَدْرَأُوا عَنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ الْمَوْتِ. So he said, then prevent yourself, protect yourself against that. إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you say it so truthful, so true about what you're saying, say, then if you, they win with us, they're never going to be killed. They will be protected, prevented, or subhanAllah, they're never going to die. Then Rasulullah sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer, then okay, protect yourself. Death coming to you. إِنَّ أَجَلُ اللَّهِ إِذَا جَاءَ لَا يُؤَخَّرُ. The time when it comes cannot be delayed, not even 1 second. Everyone will die in the time and the place meant to be. Okay. So, subhanAllah, and many people, subhanAllah, participated in the battlefield, they did not die. And the most famous one, Khalid ibn Walid, he participated in so many battles. And there's so many famous stories, they say, subhanAllah, he died in his bed. He went to die as a shaheed. That's not meant to be, subhanAllah. Then, subhanAllah, Allah, the death comes to your bed. Death comes to you. Allah said, the death you run away from, you are toward, matter of fact, you are running toward death, not away from death, but running to death. So you cannot run away from death. He said, it goes to your house, even to your bed. No matter, there's no one can stop death. No one can protect you against death. So this is subhanAllah, a few ayat talk about the action of the munafiqeen and the mu'mineen, what they say in the battle of Badr.
Allahu Akbar.